All right, guys, welcome to the Trophy Taker Outdoors Bartow Ford update with Mike Beanville. How you doing, buddy?
With Lee Sapiro.
Hey, Lee Sapiro, you ain't kidding, right? But you know who's the hero today? You and Matt. You guys killed it out there on Kissimmee on the Bartow Ford.
There was a lot of people that killed it.
Right? But still, I mean, you know, we talked about this earlier, how the weather was going to be a factor and how it would be just perfect timing again. Yep. We had cold weather.
2 years in a row.
And then all of a sudden this warm weather came in and you guys killed it.
Yeah, it just set up right again. Last year it did the same thing. This year, it's funny, but 2 years before, or 2 weeks ago, we're talking about, man, Kissimmee's tough. If you go out there and you get 10 bites and then all of a sudden, like you say, you get a warming trend. All those fish were holding off spawn and all of a sudden they all run to the bank and you could just, I mean, you could call your shots on some of it. I mean, you think about, me and my son did good with 34 and a half pounds, but we got beat by 6 pounds.
Wow.
I mean, JW and Wayne had 40 pounds on five fish.
So who was the top five?
JW and Wayne won it. Of course, Matt and I got second.
Right.
Troy and David, I believe, were
got fourth. Yep, fourth place.
And then even Big Joe Clements and his partner got fifth.
Did they? So really?
The
nice.
Third place team, I can't remember the guy's name, but super nice guys. I talked to them.
You can go to the website. Yeah, go to the website.
Or Facebook with that.
Or the TrophyTakerOutdoorsTV.com and find out all the information there. But you got more tournaments. Come on. This is the first one.
First one.
So I'm super excited about this next one.
No, it's you know, I'm going to tell you, this was me and Joe's dream child 3 years ago that, hey, we want to do a tournament series where the entry fee's a little bit more. I know it's not your standard 50 or 60 bucks.
Yep.
But we also want to pay out more. I mean, the guy, JW, I think he made $5,600 for winning.
Wow.
And then we paid Bartow Ford. I have a contingency program where if you buy a new truck at Bartow Ford and you win one of the tournaments, I hand you 10 $100 bills. So he won another $1,000 for that.
That's crazy.
So he was $6,600. And I believe he got a grand from Joe because he bought his boat. He's got an 18 Skeeter, I think he bought from Joe,
really?
Which is another $1,000. So,
man, I mean, that's incredible. You don't see that anywhere.
No. And you know, the only thing bad about this tournament, honestly, is the list of guys that fish this tournament trail is murderer's row, dude. I mean,
I bet.
There's not a guy that's ever weighed in less than 30 pounds out there that don't fish it. I mean,
it's serious.
It's serious. I mean,
because I'm telling you, because I could just imagine driving to the boat ramp in the morning going, we got a bunch of guys to beat. It's game
and,
on.
And not and a bunch of good guys. And, you know, usually if you fish a tournament, I don't mean to be this way, but if you fish a club, typically there's four or five teams that really do really well and dominate. Or you fish, even if you look at some of the bigger tours, FLW, you look at FLW and BASS, it's not every week somebody different's winning. There's 10 to 20% of those guys who consistently are the top.
Exactly.
It's not that way on our tournament series, dude. We got guys that from 1 to 100 that can catch fish on Lake Kissimmee.
And that's incredible because, you know, if you look at it at the pros of what they're doing, okay, and you look at these locals, that you've got a bunch of locals that are out there fishing
Big
all
sticks.
The time.
Yep.
So it's like,
no,
you
it's
know,
tough.
It's tough.
Yep. And you got half of them. There's guys that live out there. There's guys that fish that tournament trail that if you go tell them, hey, man, you've been to the Winter Haven chain, they're like, no, we fish Lake Kissimmee. I mean, these guys are Kissimmee homers, but it makes them studs out there, and they catch a lot of big fish.
I'm telling you, it's incredible how you know, these guys get out there. Like, you guys went out there, pre-fished a little bit. Actually, you and I went out one time, caught a nice fish, and you were telling me, you're like, man, this could be it. This could be the tournament where it's last year's repeated.
Yep. You know? And it built up from there. You know, we were out there. It was a little tougher that day. Honestly, we had some good bites, but we didn't get a lot of bites.
Right.
And each weekend from then, it got a little better and a little better. And me and my son went out there to practice a week before the tournament, we had 50 bites. I mean, we caught 35 or 40 fish, and we're like, dude, this is game on. Even though they weren't the fish we needed to win, they were more of the 2 to 4 pound range fish.
Right.
It was showing me that, hey, the lake's coming around, the lake's turning on. And even Friday out there practicing was one of those days you dream of. I mean, you could put a blindfold on, you could run to a bank on Lake Kissimmee until you hit the dirt. You could back off and start fishing and probably catch a few.
Fish.
I mean, it was just...
And that's the thing. But here's the difference between, you know, those guys that go out there and just catch fish and putting a pattern together. Because you were telling me, you said, listen, we got to put a pattern together. We got to figure out these areas and work them correctly.
Yep.
So, I mean, what you guys did was pretty awesome.
No,
finding those fish and
it was
catching
awesome.
Them. And so, I mean,
I mean, a 34.5-pound bag for us. I mean, we weighed in 30 a couple times. We actually, one time at the Winter Haven chain, weighed in 31. We had 32 on Kissimmee once. But 34.5 for us. And honestly, we had the potential of a 38 or 39-pound bag because we had one that was about 8 pounds that we got right to the boat that jumped off. It just don't happen very often. I mean, the lake's got to set up right.
What a fun day, though.
Oh,
what a
nuts.
Fun day.
I mean, me and you had the day where we had, I mean, we had 27 pounds on three fish.
Yeah.
And this was close to that, and it's amazing how when the stars align right and you happen to be doing the right thing in the right area.
Such a great feeling.
Oh, dude.
And then on
nuts.
Top of that, you fish it with your son, mm-hmm. and you catch those fish like that. It's just...
Yeah, it makes it epic fishing with my boy like that. It really does. And to watch him mature as an angler, he started off fishing... We fished a club together when he was 12,
right.
and now he's 21.
Told me you gave him the reins.
I did. For this tournament, I when I signed it up, I told him, I said, I signed it up in your name, son. This is you. You're gonna make the decisions. You're gonna run the boat. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna catch fish and run the net.
Well, I can't wait for that to happen. It'd be nice to sit back and.
Yeah, dude.
I know, right?
It was a little humbling, to be honest with you. I'm not gonna lie to you. Out of the five fish we weighed in, four of them were his. So,
yeah.
I mean, he brought the heat. But he, you know, it's funny, and we talk about fishing a lot. Confidence in fishing is a huge thing.
It is.
I mean,
it's
that belief in every single cast that I'm gonna get a bite on this cast. That means a lot because you're more in the zone. You're able to slow down more. You're able to be more methodical. And when we were idling out that morning, me and Matt looks at me and he gives me a fist bump and he goes, "Dad, I'm catching 30 pounds a day."
Wow.
And
that's confidence.
Yeah,
right?
That's confidence. And he knew he was on the right fish. And he's like, "I'm telling you, the big fish are where we're going." And he said, "We're gonna catch them." And I was like, "All right." And lo and behold, if he didn't lower the hammer, I mean, just started catching them.
That's gotta be awesome. Hey, I'd net fish like that all day, too.
Oh, big time, dude. My elbow was getting sore from running the net. I was gonna get a holster to put the net because I was
the net right there.
I was having to get it so often. I mean, we really didn't start catching fish till like one. I mean, most of our fish we caught late in the day. I think from one to three when we left to go weigh in, I think he caught 15 and I caught two. It was kind of a beat down. It was kind of ugly.
Pattern, or I know you don't want to say, but I mean, is there something that really made a difference when you guys were out there?
Honestly, making the difference was us fishing a different cover than what we typically do this time of
year.
I mean, you know, a lot of people are like, "Oh, it's a pad time of year," and it really is, and you catch a lot of good fish doing that, but we kind of broke away from that a little bit because we found that we could catch fish doing that, but it wasn't as consistent, and we all of a sudden it kind of set up to, well, okay, now we found this different type of cover that these fish seem to be relating to more. And
it could be because there's so many people fishing pads, and then those fish just, or you could just be, you found them.
Yep. And I think one thing about this time of year that a lot of people can't do, and it's funny because me and Troy, and you know, Troy Olivier is he's a local legend. I mean, this guy's caught a lot of fish around this area and a lot of big fish. And heck, every time I go fishing with him, he catches a 10 pounder.
He's always catching a big fish.
And he's taught me how important it is this time of year to slow down. And too many people can't. Too many people, you know, they want. And don't get me wrong, dude, I love throwing it out and winding it back in. I mean, there's no doubt. But this time of year is a time of year that you don't need to wind it in. You need to let it soak out there and check your phone or, you know, smoke a cigarette if you smoke.
Or, right?
You know, do whatever you do and then do it.
And
but
you're right. I mean, there are times where you really have to. I mean, there have been when we go flipping, sometimes you got to leave that bait in there for about 5 to 10 seconds and not move it. Because those fish just. You're in that you know, that zone where their official will look at that because they're mm-hmm. they're betting fish, you know. So most of them, and they're going to look at that bait and wait for it.
Yep.
So
you know, it's you know, there's certain times during the summer, you know, you're flipping grass or whatever, and you flip it in there, and as soon as it goes in, bam, your line's jumping a foot, and you got it on. But this time of year doesn't happen that way, and so many people. I mean, we watch people fish through our area, boom, boom, boom. I mean, we're just like, they're not going to catch them, and we don't worry about it because. You just don't. I mean, you've got to. It's painful to fish that slow. I mean, it really is. But then all of a sudden, when you catch an 8-pounder, you catch a 9-pounder, you're like, "Oh, wait a minute, I'm doing something right." So.
Well, I tell you what, I know we're doing. We filmed a little bit for my hometown episode that we're doing here in Polk County, and we're gonna have Grady Judd come in and sit in with us.
Exciting.
But I want to talk to you about how great Polk County is for fishing.
Oh,
I mean, you and I went to Lake Fanny, Winter Haven Chain, Kissimmee, and. How great is it to be in a a city like this where you can just catch so many fish.
And fish, you know, the thing I like about it, with us having the variance of the lakes we got, if I want to go, say, if I want to fish deep one time,
yeah,
I can go somewhere and fish 20 foot of water. Yeah. If I say, hey, I want to go flip reeds at a lake, I'm like, okay, that place has got reeds. I can go flip reeds. If you want to go say, okay, I'm going to go try to, you know, kind of whatever you want to do, you yeah. can find a lake in our area because we got so many, and so many that's got good fish in it.
And it's different fishing too as well.
Yep.
Let's go back to Lake Fanning. Remember Lake Fanning when yep. we were fishing that? We were throwing topwater frogs.
You didn't have to
all
say
of a sudden,
that name
you went
out
ahead
there.
And threw that swim bait.
Yeah, throw a swim bait.
Just killed it.
Crushing them.
Big, big fish.
Yep.
And we got footage of that.
Yep.
And then we went to Lake Kissimmee
yep.
and fished out there. You caught a real big one there. That
yeah,
was
one almost
awesome
nine.
Fish.
I mean, that was
and
just.
Now we were fishing pads. Few,
yeah, the video's a little scary because we almost missed that fish three times, but
that
that's all right.
That was crazy. I mean, that fish came by and yep. it wrapped around a path, and you missed a big one that day
yep.
on a pad. So, I mean, all yep. in all, pre-fishing for the tournament was great.
Mm-hmm.
But as far as, you know, our hometown here, it's such a great place. I mean,
no, it really is. Polk County's awesome. And you know, it's big. I think it's 33,000 square miles or some huge. I mean, it's just a monster county. But, you know, we sit here and talk about the fishing, but realistically, the Florida state largest buck ever killed in the state of Florida is killed in Polk County.
Right here in Polk County.
So, yeah. I mean, the deer hunting's not bad
no.
either. I mean,
the
you got
the
turkey hunting's good. I mean, heck, right here at Bartow Ford, we got a turkey that lives behind us here that, I mean, he's behind fences, so you can't hunt him, but, dude,
yeah.
he's a hammer.
You drive by and you're just itching. Yeah.
I mean, but. Polk County's wonderful. I mean, it really is. And it's a, I mean, I lived in Hillsborough for a while, and nothing against that, but, you know, I want to raise my kids somewhere more like this.
Yeah,
where
this is an outdoor community.
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing about Polk County and living here?
Man, I just too much. The people,
the atmosphere.
I mean, it really is. I mean, we get, there's not, the, we don't have the, I was down in Boca Raton 2 weeks ago, and the traffic there, I mean, it was just insane.
Yeah.
Here, we've got big, but we've not got big enough to where we have those crazy traffic issues.
Right.
And
we're right here. Polk County is right between Orlando and Tampa. So
yep.
we've got the best of both worlds. We want to run to Orlando in 45 minutes, 30 minutes to Tampa.
Yep.
You can't beat it.
No,
so
we're
it's really
square
cool.
in the middle.
Yeah.
And you know, we got a lot of good outdoor activities. As you know, I do a lot of bike riding, a lot of running and stuff
yep.
like that. And I mean, we got the Van Fleet Trail in Polk City, which is amazing. It's you can go 60 miles on your bike and not have to worry about getting run over by cars.
Yep.
We got the Fort Fraser Trail right here beside Bartow Ford that, you know, you can go out there and run and ride on.
Carter Road, which is a
dynamite mountain bike place.
You and I are going to go out there and do a little filming and,
yep.
and ride our bikes out there, which I can't keep up with you. You're a beast when it comes to those trails, man.
Yep.
And we're going to see Leroy. He's
yep.
going to come in and talk.
Leroy's
to
a good guy.
Bit. So, yeah, we're excited. This is a great great city. We went downtown and saw the shops. They had Saturday, I believe, they had the flea market down
yep.
there, the marketplace.
Yep.
That was a great place. So there's a lot to do here in Polk County. It's
second Thursday.
Yeah.
You can't forget the second Thursday because it's the food truck rally
at
downtown
right?
Lakeland.
Know,
and let
right?
me tell you, if you haven't experienced the food truck rally here, it's awesome. I mean, you got – the cool thing I like about food trucks and – is typically they don't have a giant menu.
Yeah.
So the stuff they do, they do it well.
Yeah,
and
really good.
I mean, there's a couple places. I mean, give a shout out to the Rolling Gourmet, but their cheeseburger there is just absolutely
I haven't had it. I want to try it.
Ridiculous. I mean, it's funny because there's usually 20 trucks there, and I take my wife, I'm like, all right, let's go look at this. She goes, no, I'm going to the Rolling Gourmet and getting a cheeseburger. So, I mean, that's a fun thing to do.
And that's the thing. Like I said, this is our hometown, and you know, I wanted to do an episode just to show everybody, hey, listen, we're an hour away from saltwater, and we got all these lakes right here in Polk
yep.
County. So it really, living in Florida and Central Florida is really, we're blessed.
Oh.
You know, there's so much to
yep.
do. So, you know, I'm happy and
The weather here.
The weather. Perfect.
I mean, it's you know? Not the prettiest in the world today, but I mean, how many days of sunshine do we get a year?
Exactly.
I mean, it's ridiculous.
Exactly.
So, I mean, it definitely it's a good place, and like I say, a great place to raise your family and hang out.
Well, let's talk about what you guys have. Any deals? Any trucks going on right now? Or
it's just honestly, it's nice right now being a Ford dealer because I say this a lot, but one is. We're in truck country. I mean, Polk County is truck country.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, about 75% of what we sell is trucks. And right now, with a light-duty truck, the 150 just can't be beat. I mean,
yeah.
and then you get it, take it even a step farther than that, the Super Duty with the 250 and 350, the most powerful diesel we've ever had. We never see them in service. They run and ride good. I mean, we just got a great product. And then you got Ford, who who backs that product with a great incentive most of the time.
Right.
They want, you know, we've maintained truck leadership, I think, 35 years in a row or something, and they're never going to lose that. So whatever it takes for them to sell the trucks, they do. And we just, I mean, last month we sold 87 Super Duty trucks from Bartow Ford.
Wow.
I mean, Bartow Ford. It's in Bartow, Florida. It's not very big. We sold, I think, 87 Super Duties and 50 Light Duties. So, I mean.
But that's the thing. You guys have such a wide variety of trucks because you have so many that they can just come here and just pick out whichever one they want.
I think last time I checked, we had $47 million in inventory.
Oh, my God.
So, yeah. I mean, a lot of inventory. But, it's funny, but we get a lot of people trapped. We're a destination store. We're not Bartow Ford's. Most time, I mean, people don't drive by and go, oh, crap, there's Bartow Ford.
Yeah.
I'm going to pull in.
Right.
Most of the time, people are like, I'm driving to Bartow Ford. And because their local dealer may have four trucks or five trucks, and then, you know, they don't want to deal on them. And with us, I mean, if you're driving from out of our area, you're plus business for us. You go out there right now, I think – last I checked, we have almost 300 available light duties, and then we have close to 150 super duty trucks available. Had more than that, we sold 87 last month. So
incredible.
Yep,
we're
blessed.
They can go to bartowford.com.
Yep. Search our whole inventory.
Check out the inventory. And if they want to check out the Bartow Ford tournament.
Yep. You can go to the Elite Pro Team Facebook. If you go on the Facebook and you go to Bartow Ford Elite Pro Team or Toho Marina, that's super spot. I mean, Toho Marina does a phenomenal job with our tournament, but you can go to the Toho Marine, or you can go to Elite Pro Team on Facebook, and
Facebook.
You can get the dates of the tournament. Okay. You can sign up for the tournament, and get
And we'll have that link as well on Trophy Taker Outdoors TV.
I think our next one is in May. It's like the first week of May. Mm-hmm. So, and we'll do one in July, and I think we do one in September, and then we hold the classic in November. So,
I'm super excited. I'm fishing this next one. It's going to be awesome. Can't wait. So, well, I appreciate it, Mike.
No,
and you guys, if you guys want more information, go to bartowford.com. If you want to see any of their inventory, go to trophytakertv.com for more information about this episode and any of the other episodes we have.
We're all in.
All right, welcome to Trophy Taker Outdoors, Bartow Ford Outdoor Update. Your host, Lee Shapiro, Mike Beanbow, Steve Hendricks, and Mr. Grady Judd. How you doing?
It's my honor to be with you. I'm doing good.
Thank you, sir. We appreciate you coming down and talking to us. I want to talk to you a little bit about the clay shoot that you guys have coming up March 16th.
We're all excited about the clay shoot. It's one of our two big fundraisers, so we can donate money to our charity. And then we turn around and we take that money and we reinvest it in our community. So when people come out to do our Jeeping with Judd,
right,
or our Busting Clays with Sheriff Grady Judd, every bit of that money, 100% after we pay the bills, goes directly into the charity.
That's amazing. Nice. Steve, you and I have done a lot of clay shoots together and a lot of charities. So something like this is really special, especially for our community here in Polk County. So how many years you guys been doing this?
You know, this is about our seventh or eighth year doing this. And it started out because people wanted to donate money to help the sheriff's office. And we did not have a vehicle by which to take donations. You know, the government just cannot go out and ask for it and take money, even though it doesn't sound like a bad idea.
Yep.
So we began the charity. And quite frankly, Bartow Ford, many other businesses in the community, as well as just thousands and thousands of people, have worked very closely with us. And the end result is we reinvested in the community.
And that's great, you know. Yeah. I mean, between Trophy Taker Outdoors, Bartow Ford, we try to get, you know, kids and families involved in the outdoors. This is something special for everybody, you know. So doing something like this with Polk County Sheriffs, you know, it says a lot about yourself and your deputies.
Well, I like to brag on the men and women of the Sheriff's Office. They're simply the very best. But it's not enough just to do a good job.
Right.
We have to be good stewards in the community. And we have the opportunity to see those that are less fortunate. We have the opportunity to see the children who really need help and don't know how to get help. We need to always be mindful that it's our duty and responsibility to look out for the best interests of everyone in the community. And we have such a huge, huge support system with Bartow Ford, Trophy Takers, and all of our businesses that help us out. So this is a blessed community when you look at the awesome people in this community that give back.
And Mike and I were just talking about this earlier. You know, Polk County has so much to offer, you know, not just in the outdoors, but activities for kids and families, you know. So we're really blessed to be able to live in a city like this. So for you to do a charity event like this, clay shooting is one of my favorite things to do. I know we've all shot out there and, you know, Steve, talk about last year's.
Well, a couple of things. I got involved with it back in 2013, and as a civilian, I said, hey, can I work on the committee? And they said, sure, any helping hand we can have. And so we started in 2013 working. I think back then we raised about, in 2012, we might have raised $37,000, $38,000. I think in 2013, we raised $62,000, and then it worked on its way up. Now we're over the $100,000 mark. On this is a one-day event that nets $100,000. And I mean, it's pretty impressive, but when you see all the people that get involved with it, it's like a well-oiled machine. We have 360, 380 shooters that come out to this event. We work a week or so ahead of time getting everything ready, the tent set up. I actually work helping train the trappers. We have volunteers for every division within the Sheriff's Department, all have a responsibility.
Right.
We have a huge group of people that show up, as well as from the community, come in and pitch in to make this thing happen. It starts about 8 o'clock in the morning. It starts for some of us at 6 a.m. in the morning. But it starts about 8 o'clock in the morning.
We have breakfast. Lunch.
We have a shoot. We have lunch. We have the prizes and the raffles and all the
stuff.
Fun stuff that we do. And we're out of there at 1 o'clock. And so for that to happen at that scale in that short a time
it's amazing.
But they're very organized, and seeing it firsthand from an inside viewpoint is really impressive to see how everybody works and how everybody is very, very responsible for their portion that they're supposed to do, whether it be fundraising, whether it be organizing a shoot, ordering supplies, making sure the manpower is there. They have to have folks there because we have a lot of equipment there during the week, so they have to have people there 24/7. We actually go a little further and we have do a little prep work on the site ahead of time, and the Sheriff's Department helps, you know, make sure that happens as well. But the place is up and running like a well-oiled machine,
and it gets bigger and bigger every year.
We have a lot of fun and we raise a lot of
money. Yes, and that's great, you know, because, you know, this charity goes to a lot of different places, correct?
It really does. When one of our base responsibilities of this charity is to look out for the law enforcement memorial at the Sheriff's Office. We know that in order to have a free and safe society, that law enforcement officers give their life, die in the line of duty.
Mm-hmm.
So this charity takes care of that. We actually have a scholarship, a college scholarship, in the name of our deputies who died in the line of duty.
That's amazing.
Wow. Yeah.
We also donate money to Florida Sheriff's Youth Ranches and to help those children that are less fortunate. But in addition to that, our board, our charitable board, approves and goes out and we look for opportunities to help in the community. We tell folks, we raise this money so we can reinvest it in the community to make our community better. And quite frankly, that's only possible because of people like Steve, Bartow Ford, Trophy Takers, and all the other folks. I'm excited every year, and when I see all the people that come out early on Saturday morning to have a good time and to help in the community, I want them to know that that donation is going to be well vetted, and it's going to go for a specific, worthwhile cause. And at the end of the day, when you look around Polk County and you see this great community we have, it's not just because of our charity, but it's because of all the charities and the charitable people who are so totally awesome in this county.
Well, it's amazing that you've done this for so long, and you give back to the community the way you do, and you know, we really do appreciate it. You know, so if you guys want more information on this event, go to trophytakertv.com. You can also contact at bustingclays.org, or you can call them at 863-298-4990.
You can also go to polksheriff.org, and you can find out about more information about the Sheriff's Department, about these fundraising events, the Jeeping with Judd event, the Judd Jog. I think there's a concealed weapons course that's coming up that is managed and run by sheriff's deputies. Mm-hmm. So if you ever wanted to get your concealed weapons, that's something. But all that information is on polksheriff.org, and or you can give us a call here, and we'll get you to the right place.
Absolutely. Sheriff, thank you, Sheriff. Appreciate it very much.
Thank you very much, and that's the reason I need Steve.
I know. Steve knows everything.
He is the businessman.
He's got it tightened up.
He does. He does have it tightened up.
And don't let him tell you he can't shoot. I mean, you want him on your team whenever it comes to shooting the clays.
We're going
to
be out there shooting. We can't wait to be out there and see you again, and thank you very much for coming on the show with us.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
We'll see you guys. God bless Fishing and Camo.